guys. It is 4:30 and it is Tennis Tabata Thursday. So if you are a tennis player or a racquet sport player, this is going to be the Tabata for you. We're going to really focus on agility and we're going to focus on balance. And if you're not a tennis player, don't worry, you're still going to get a great workout because we're still going to focus on things that you need to be working on as well. So you can see I've got a bunch of equipment here, a jump rope if you've got one. Don't need it, but if you've got one, wonderful. A band, we're going to be doing some ankle band work, so if you've got a resistance band, that would be great. I've also got a ball, don't need it. I mean, again, this is all optional, with the exception maybe of the hand weights, which are kind of nice, but you could grab a couple of cans of soup or something. With the ball, we're going to just do some isometric lunge twists. And the free weights. So let's go ahead. If you've got access to any of those things, go ahead and grab them now. Also, if you want to put your name in the comments, that would be great. That way I know you are working out with me this morning. And we're going to go ahead, start with a warm-up first. Let's do it. Okay. Not yet. Hold low, breathe it in and out. Again, breathe in and warm up again. So reach forward, forward, two more. Hands on your quads. Plant up, plant. You just warm up the muscles. Now roll it up, roll it. The dynamic warm up. It just gets those muscles going, gets the blood flowing through the elbows. Bigger arms. Now step touch to the right. Long and strong. Squeeze those arms. Now add your hamstrings. Pull, pull. Breathe through it. Rhomboid arms. Stretch it back. Four, three. Rat pull down. Pull, pull. Two, three. Take the knees up. Knees up. Four, three. And march it out. March it. March it wide. March it in. Touch it wide. Right foot forward, push it up. Up. Two more. Hold here, breathe in. Stretch it out. Press on the heel. Glute goes back. Point the toes down. Two more. Hold it up. Come down on the foot. Stretch through your hip and your quad. Our little single leg squats, keeping it small. We're not going to deep, just little motions. March it out. Four, three, left foot, push it up. Up, good. Two more. Hold here, breathe in, breathe out. Point the toe down. Alright, come up on your foot. Stretch it. Just relax through the hip. Press the hip forward. And the knee goes down. Little squats. Keeping them small. Breathe. Two more. March it out. March it. Release it. Relax it. Take a deep breath in. Breathe and out. One more time. Breathe in. Excellent. All right, grab a sip of water. And we're starting with our first Tabata. Okay. We're going to start with a pivot lunge. I see that Brenda and Christina are on board with us this morning, so fantastic, you ladies. Thanks for getting up early and working out with me this morning. We're going to start with a pivot lunge and then a squat hop. So I like to keep hands together, and it's a pivot down. Alright, now this is kind of like a twist-up backhand, forehand. So if you're a tennis player, you can get in there with those. I think we started. So again, if you're not, you don't have to do your forehand backhand. Just make sure that your knee doesn't come over the toes and that you're going down into that deep lunge. Pivoting. Solid core. Oh, now we're working. Okay, we can double lean on this one. So keep going. Really think about that thick leg gliding down. Solid through your core. You're just pivoting on the balls of your feet. Oh, yes. Shake it. Oh, that was a long. That was probably 40 seconds. Same thing again. So it's a lunge pivot. Now I didn't even get to squeeze my palms together, so I'm doing a little bit isometric tricep workout, shoulders as well. Balancing into that lunge as far as you can go. Shake it. Alright, this one, it's a squat low, pop, pop, squat, pop, pop. Squat, pop, pop. Balance. Breathe out, push up. Shake it. One more round. Now if you're not doing the hop, the high impact, I'll show you your option. Squat, step, step, squat, step, step, squat. Alright, here's your low impact. Otherwise, it's a squat, hop and back. Shake it. Alright. So again, back to your forehand, backhand, get low into that pivot. So again, you can work the forehand, backhand, or you're just pressing together. The goal here, try to get that knee touching the floor. Solid chest up. Shake it. One more. Squeeze the palms, or the forehand, backhand. Here we go, pivot. Out. Full range of motion. Down into that lunge. Front knee stays behind the toes. Back knee drives it. There we go. Oh. Oh, I missed it. It's a squat. Hop forward and back. Balancing. You're probably going to feel you can balance better on one leg than the other. Breathe out, push up. Here we go, shake it. Don't even stretch. Hip flexors and quads. Stretch it out. You've got a 1 minute recovery. Right, so if it's Tabata, it's always, you've never done it before. It's 8 rounds of 20 seconds, 10 second break in between, and then a 1 minute recovery, which is what we're in now. That gives you time to stretch, time to release, time to grab a sip of water. Okay, if you've got a jump rope, and if you've got an ankle bend, that's what you're going to want now. Okay, starting with jump rope.
I see Suzanne is on board with us. Good morning, Suzanne. Again, if you don't have a jump rope, that's okay. You can march it out solid, or you can pretend jump without a rope. You're going to want your ankle bend if you've got it. We're going to be doing some squat walks low. Here we go. Now, get that heart rate up. You can single foot jump, single block. Take a break. Breathe easy.
This is great.
Oh, whoops. We are in a TABATA right now.
Goodness, Alex, could you straight? I can't hear this down stop. I think with the jump rope. Whoops. Now I'm on board. Oh my gosh, you guys, if you've got a band, low, walk, monster walk. Now, you can do the same thing without the band, right? The goal is the chest stays up and you're in that low squat. Don't need to get the band. Release it. Alright. So again, don't feel like you need to have your band. Just get a little more AB depth to work with the band. Here we go. So I'm keeping low. Got about 3 steps back and forward. You can do however many you want. Keep your chest up, solid through the core. Breathe. Alright, to the rope. Alright, here we go.
3, 2, 1, work!
Double it out. So this TABATA music is designed for virtual classes. A little bit different than I normally use. So I'm not used to the countdown. There you go. Ah, deep breath, exhale. Last round of jumping before we go back to our trampoline squats. 20 seconds. Oh, such a great cardio workout. There's the jump rope. Man, try to do it every day. I always do rope with every TABATA class. Alright, last 2 rounds.
3, 2, 1,
oh, here we go. With the band or without. Keep that tension on if you've got the band. Without the band, sink a half inch lower. Breathe, breathe, breathe. You want to feel all quads, glutes, knee strings. Release it. Alright, last round you guys of TABATA 2. Here we go. Wide feet, low squat. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Keep that chest up. We don't want to be bending down, right? You've got to get the glutes low. Shake it out. Keep that bend for later. You got it? You can just get those from physical therapists. They'll often give those out. Say, oh, you know, I really need one of those ankle resistance bands. Stretch it out. Hips and quads. And stretch. Out of glutes. Up and in. Excellent. Sip of water. We've got some push-ups. And then some planks with opposite arm and leg lifts coming up. So we're going to be down on the floor for the next TABATA. Push-ups to start. Oops. Okay, guys. always think of Brenda with these because I like to push up off the weight. I got the idea from Brenda. Takes a little bit of pressure off the wrist so you can do a regular push up or off your weights. All right, here we go. We are starting Tabata 3. Just a regular push up first. Hands wide at the chest, elbows go out, down and up. So I'm doing an intermediate push-up. You can do a full length with your feet a little wider apart, or you can go basic push-up. You can even mix and match. Press it back, stretch it out. Alright, this time stay low and pulse it. Ready. Pump it out. Little pulses. Working that upper body strength. Breathe, breathe, breathe. And yes. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Press it. Alright. Hands forward. On your knees or toes. It's going to be an opposite arm regular. Here we go, reach in. Opposite arm and leg comes up. Solid through the core. Notice I can go on my knees, or I can go full in. Think about pushing out. Arm and leg, keeping your core solid. Squeezing that glute, press back. So you're getting that lower back, you're getting that glute, you're getting the core in the front. And you're extending with your arms and legs. Here we go, lift, lift. Core is balancing. Probably better on one side than another. It's not too unusual. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Press back. Back to the full range push-ups. So again, you want to get depth on these. Here we go. Down and up. Breathe out, push up. Cool these to Brenda push ups right here. Brenda push ups right off the weights. Love it, love it, love it. Exhale on the push up. Press back. Stretch it out. Stay low, pulse it out. There you go, you're in the low zone. Little pulses. Breathe, breathe. Keep going. Oh, we're nearly there. Oh, brace it. Ah, bend your planks. Elbows down, palms facing down and forward. Here we go. Whoops. Arm and leg lifts. Opposite arm and leg. Exhale on the lift up. Again, do the same thing. Off your knees. Think about stretching long. Think about as the leg comes up, the glute gets squeezed. Press back. Last round for Tabata 3. Shoulders relaxed and down. Here we go. Reach. Exhale up. Neck in line with your spine. Breathe out, lift. Great cool workout. So essential for those racquet players. Press down. It is a lot harder than it looks. Alright, come on up. Stretch. Shoulders in the front. Upper trapezius. And switch. Release it. Relax it. Nice job. Grab a sip of water. We're on to the next Tabata. So bring your heart rate down a little bit. Grab a sip of water. If you've got a ball to hold on to, or maybe even a light weight, we're going to be doing some dynamic lunges with some twists. also going to be doing some high agility. If you can imagine you've got an agility ladder or a line in front, you're just going to jump across that imaginary line, little feet, and then come back. All right, so imagine you've got a line that you're trying to jump forward and back over. That's going to be our second Tabata. First, though, grab your ball, or you can grab a weight. If you've got core strength, you can use a weight. So it's a lunge, twist. Here we go. Deep lunge, twist. Chest stays up. Breathe out. Now, if you've got a weight, very important, keep that core tight through that twist. Right? Because you've got that extra center of gravity shift. Alright. Again. If you don't have a weight or a ball, cross your arms. I'll show you what that one looks like. Here we go. Deep lunge, twist. So you can hold those arms out. Get that twist in there. Do the same thing with your ball or with your weight. You might even want to bring that weight in just to give your core a little break. Alright. Water modifications. Okay, so imagine you've got that line in front. You are working hard, forward and back. Looks like this. Quick feet. This is high agility. You're a tennis player, racquetball player. You need to be quick on your feet. Small little steps. Back and forward. Alright. Now I've got three lines going forward and back, so I'm going to start in the opposite direction just to counterbalance. Here we go. So now I'm leading with my opposite leg. I'm doing about six before I go back again. Kind of a stickler to keeping it all balanced. Alrighty. Make your lunge twist with a weight, with a ball, or with those arms out. Here we go. Lunge twist. Front heel is down. Back heel is up. Solid through the core. Breathe. Again, without the ball, straight arms.
Three, two, one, break.
Nice. With the weight. Ready.
Three, two, one, work.
Lunge, twist. I even want to bring it in. I've got an 8-pound weight here, and that's more than enough for me. So I want to bring that weight in to the chest on my switch. Breathe, breathe, breathe.
Three, two, one, break.
Excellent.
Three, two, one, work.
Here we go. Into that agility. A little bit. Thin little line that you are jumping over.
Three, two, one, break.
Shake it.
Three, two, one.
Here we go, last one. Keep that core solid. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Shake it out. Head stays up. There's our culmination for Tabata 4. Down the hatch. Alright. Knees down, hips forward. Alright, we're going to the bands around the ankles. A little bit of upper body work. So again, if you've got those weights, those soup cans, you're going to want those. So grab a sip of water. And your weights and your band. Get ready for those coming up.
Okay. If you go on loose band, you can kind of do a figure eight, cross it over, if you like. Okay. We're going to stop bicep curls to the front. Elbows forward of your hips. Try to get that extension all the way down. With that extension down, it hits that base of the bicep. Alright. Breathe out that medial head. Keep the tension on if you can. Now, if you don't have a band, you're probably getting your leg up a little higher. And you're still balancing on that opposite foot. Release it. Same thing. Shoulders back. Elbows forward, but switch to the other leg. Here we go. We're lifting. Lift. You're on your other leg now. So we're doing the same thing. Just switching legs. Exhale on the up. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Keep going.
Three, two, one, breathe.
Excellent. Release it. Okay. For those tennis players, you know, or racquet sport players, you know, getting those rotator cuff work, very important. So this time, it's lead with the elbows. Up and down. Elbows no higher than your shoulders. Balance on that other leg. Breathe, breathe, breathe.
Three, two, one.
Nice. Release it. Still with the rotator cuff. It's going to be the flat downs. I'm going to have to grab even lighter weights. So I'm going to do that.
Three, two, one.
Here we go. Flap it down, other leg. Out to the side. Here's what it looks like. Got to get my rhythm going here. Here we go. Still working those rotator cuffs. I can even feel my back muscles kicking in. Shoulders, deltoids. Release it. Alright. Little stretch, upper traps, switch legs. This time it's tricep kickbacks. So push it, when the knuckles face the floor, you stop. Think about balancing as well. Breathe out, keep your core solid. That squeeze at the top is what's getting your tricep contracting.
Three, two, one, break.
Release it. Same thing, tricep kickback, other leg though. Ready.
Three, two, one,
there we go, squeeze it. Squeeze it. Breathe out. Breathe. Squeeze at the top. Balance, balance.
Three, two, one, break.
Oh, release it. Switch legs. We're going to finish up. Reverse fly. Leg out to the side again.
Three,
lift.
One,
here we go. Lift it up. Breathe out. Balance as much as you can. Elbows and arms as high and as wide as you want to go. Now, if I go a little lighter, I can go straighter arms. So if you feel like, oh man, my weight's a little lighter, that's okay. You can get a little more range of motion, straighter arms. A little bit heavier, you want to do that bend at the elbows.
Three, two, one,
here we go, switch legs. Breathe out, lift up. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Keep going, team, we're nearly there. Release it. Nice to have those options. You go a little bit lighter and then a little bit more range going wider versus heavier. You can get a little more range also, but your elbows bent. All right, let's go ahead and stretch it out. Start with your back. Curl it under. Curl it under, roll it up. One more time. Toes out. Shoulder to knee. Shoulder to knee. Excellent. Roll it up. Oh.
Oh man, my traps are feeling this. They sure do. Release through the cool greater sip of water. Man, are we already on the last Tabata before we hit the floor? Yes, we are. So grab a sip of water and then get ready for your last Tabata coming up. We've got some lateral hops, kind of like a skater with a little bit more balance. We're starting with toe taps. So it's a single leg on one leg balance, glutes back, and you're just going to toe tap. Now the goal on this one, the core is solid, the abs are locked in. Your leg is dynamically working, and this leg is isometrically working. The key, no knees over the toes. Push back, right? If you're feeling knee pain, shake it. If you're feeling knee pain, it's because your knee is too far forward. You gotta sit back a little more. You even might wanna come up a little bit more. But the goal on this is to squat low. So you can see here, I'm pushing back my glute. My core is solid, my chest is up. My weight is in my heel, not my toes. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Shake it. Okay. So if you tennis players again, it's a skater balance. Skater balance. Alright, so this is your move. You want to get some distance. Now you of course can step it balance. Step it balance. If you want a little more cardio, you can just go to a skater. That's your option. Breathe. Alright. Excellent. One more. So again, if you want the cardio, skate quick. These tennis players, it's about stick it. Alright, stick and balance. A little more challenge, get down low. Sometimes we think we squat lower than we are. And then when we see ourselves, it's like, no, I'm not really squatting much at all. So get low, shake it. Alright, that single knee toe tap, solid core. Back with the glutes, toe taps, knees behind the toes. Oh yes, I'm telling you, this leg is working just as hard as this one. But keep the hip pushed back, keep the weight in your heel, keep the core solid. Shake it. We'll stretch those hip flexors at the end. Push back. Other side, toe taps. Again, my weight is in my heel. Working on that lower body strength, a little bit of agility, mostly strength, balance, and core. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Keep going, guys. Crawl with those ones. Ooh, shake it. All right, back to the skater sticks. Here we go, balance. Get some distance. Again, you want that challenge? Skate log. Oh, you want to be able to stick it. Stick it. Now my core is pulled in. I'm not letting it all hang out. I am working hard, squatting low, and pulling in my core. You need to do the same. All right, last one, 20 seconds, here we go. Here we go. Stick it. Slow. Keep those abs in tight. Breathe out as you jump across. Oh man, you should be working hard. And there you have it. Shake it. Let's get those hip flexors stretched. Knees down, hip forward. Oh, that feels good. All that flexion in my old body. Feels good to stretch it out. Out of glutes, bring that knee up and in. And switch. Knee comes up and in. Oh, release it. Hammies at the back.
toes up, heels down. You're going to get your hamstring up into the glute and your gas drop right under there. And switch. Oh man, you guys, what a way to start the day. If you're a tennis player or a racket player, I hope you have picked up some good moves. And when you go down to the court, you can do a warm-up, a dynamic warm-up maybe with some of these exercises. Right now though, we're going down on the floor for the core. If you've got a light weight, go ahead and keep that. So I'll meet you down there with your weight, lying down on the floor. Grab a sip of water. Okay guys, we're starting with Russian twists. No rest for the wicked, right? Okay. Solid core, always great to be working. It's just a side-to-side twist. This is also great for you tennis players. Oh, we're on, I guess. Side-to-side. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Now, if it's too much with that weight, that's okay. You can go without the weight. You can hold your lighter ball. Take a break. Oh, what I like to do actually is come down and do the hips up. That just feels good for me. Roll back up. Again, you can choose to lean back with your feet elevated. And maybe you're thinking, man, my lower back is hurting. You just come on up, sit tall. You still keep the core tight. You're just taking a little more pressure off your lower back. Then you can go back down if you like. Take a break. Up with the hips. Okay. Hands behind the head. Two feet coming down. Four. One leg at a time. There we go. Breathe out, lift up. Exhale on the up. Squeeze the feet together at the bottom if you're going 2 feet. Solid through the core. Don't let that back hyperextend. Break right here, up with the hips. One more. The minute your back curves up off your mat, you start and go back up. Here we go. So if you've got a lot of core strength and you're keeping it tight, you might go all the way down. Squeeze the feet at the bottom. If you're maybe taller, you might just go halfway down. So find your sweet spot. Take a break. Alright, crunch it. Basic. Straight up. Get between your chin and toes.
There
you go. Chin up, twist up. You're looking straight up. I don't want to be feeling this. My neck is getting a workout. You don't want it. It's the upper abductors. Straight up. My chin is trying to touch the sky. I even stop at the top. Take a break. Again, you can just rest. I like to go hips up. One more. Same thing.
Here
we go. Chin up, chest up. Do a little more challenge. Cross those arms at the back. Squeeze. Stop at the top for half a second. Really working hard. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Excellent. V sit up. Make a V with your body. Kind of like a V. Right? And then you can either lift up one leg up and down, one leg. Or if you've got the core strength, just resting your feet. You've got a built in foot rest. It's your other foot. Exhale up. So again, it's one leg or two. Switch. Last one. In that V position. One leg or two.
Three, two, one, work.
Here we go. Lift it up. Either 2 legs at a time or 1 leg. Upper body comes up. Breathe out, lift. Again, you're resting the upper foot on your lower foot. Oh, there you have it. Roll onto your back. Big stretch. Arms to the feet, bend the knees, lower down. Stretch it out. Other side. While you stretch the other side, I'm going to put the cool down music on. So keep stretching, press those knees down. And now hug the knees into the chest. Breathe in and breathe out. Toes down, heels up. With the flat feet, you get that nice gastroc stretch and the hamstring stretch. Both feet together for your inner thighs. Gently open up, press out with your elbows against your legs. Stretch those adductors. Release it. Get a little momentum. One rock, two rocks, and three rocks up. Ah, that's the fun part of the workout right there. Hands on your quads. Roll it up and hold it. Roll it all the way. Shoulders back. Upper traps. Down away with the shoulder. And switch. One foot behind, out with the hip, with that iliotibial bend, reach up and over. Nice stretch all the way. Alright, and I know that a number of you are going to be looking at this not live. Katie and others that maybe decide they want to sleep in just a wee bit, and they'll work out later on this afternoon. So I'm giving you guys a shout out. If you are watching this video and you have done it to completion, take a deep breath in. If you have done it to completion, kudos to you. And your body is saying, gracias. Namaste. Have a wonderful day.